In this video, we're going to take a look at the Cogent DataHub Bridging interface. I've already started the DataHub, and if I double-click, we can bring up the Properties window. And I'll just show you that I've already made a couple of connections. One of them is to the OPC Foundation's Quick Start Demo Server. And under here, there is some static data. And these three inputs here, I want to map those to some data that's being generated by a second OPC server that I've connected to, a top server. And under the top server, I'm going to take some of this generated ramp data, and I want to map it and bridge it to these three inputs here. So, if I look at the bridging interface and open up Configure Bridges, you can see the bridging interface is divided into three different sections. We've got a source panel, a destination panel, and a panel where we can define some transformations on the data as it passes through the bridge. So let's get started. So first I want to choose the first source point. So I'll open up top server again. And the first one I'm going to choose is this ramp float 1. And you remember I wanted to bridge that to the input 1 variable. And that's all we need to do. I expand this a little bit. We click. I'm not going to apply a transform to this first one. You see we've created a bridge. If we come over to our data now, you can see that input 1 is now updating with the data from the ramp float 1 variable. So let's go do that again. I'll choose float 10. This time I'm going to put it into input 2. And this time I'm going to apply a linear transformation to this. I'm going to multiply it by 10. Press OK. And you come back, we can see that we've got input 1. And then input 2 is, happens to be the same number, but multiplied by 10. And if we just go through again, we can do a similar thing. 0.3, I'll say, just so it stands out. Using these linear transformations, we can apply scaling, and we can also do range mapping to clamp a value between a specific range so that the input can be mapped properly to the output. So let's apply that. And as you can expect here, we've got our three mappings. So that's how bridging is configured. You can also bridge, let's say we want to bridge this, and we wanted to select a few of these variables and put them into a new data domain that we're going to use for something else. Maybe we're going to tunnel it somewhere, or we're going to use it in some other notification. We can actually create data points. If we come here, and I call this, well, let's call this my test domain. Use the colon separator, and I'll create a new point, my test point 1. And then if I, so I'll just do this as a direct copy. If I press apply, you can see that down here we've got a test domain created. If we come and look in our data viewer, where is it? Underneath here. There's our new test domain, and there's my point 1 with the value from the top server being bridged into it. So we can make direct bridging connections between data points that already reside in one server, bridge them to a data point in another server, or we can bridge from a server to a point we create within the data hub that we may want to use for something else. So very simply, that shows you the bridging interface and how to configure bridges with the data hub. For any information on some of the features in this interface that we've not covered, then please refer to the documentation that we have at www.cogentdatahub.com.